At noon tonight, we could have taken Tom Messner's word that it was crazy cold out there tonight, but we thought it would be illustrative to hit the streets with a camera and an intrepid reporter.
The responsibility for that assignment fell to News Channel 5's David Charnes. We are sorry, David. He's been out talking to the very cold people of Chittenden County and joins us live from the newsroom. Hi, David.
Well, hey there, Steph and George. You could say it's toasty here in the newsroom at a good 72 degrees, but the temperature here in Colchester actually just fell to -2, and people all across the area were preparing for extreme cold today.
Gonna have a bunch of blankets, gonna wear a lot of pajamas, and I'm gonna warm up.
Good advice from 9-year-old Grace Cunningham as overnight temperatures drop well below zero.
It's really freezing.
Well below freezing. Burlington hit a balmy 12 degrees Wednesday, Plattsburgh not far behind with a whole 9 notches on the mercury.
Well, last winter was a fluke, I guess you could say.
2012 officially down in the record books as the second warmest year for Burlington. But this cold weather we're seeing in the first few days of 2013 isn't that unusual.
What we've seen the last couple of weeks or the last week seems abruptly different, but basically this is normal.
Cooler winds coming off the warmer water making for this picture-perfect moment on Lake Champlain.
I'm from Iowa, so I was used to slightly cold weather, but this is a totally different experience.
Emily Marcus and Chris Dunn are visiting from Baltimore. The high there Wednesday, 38 degrees. And they say these sub-zero temps won't stand in their way.
We'll wander from shop to shop and eat in between.
But, we'll tough it out, dress warmly.
Well, the below zero temperatures can also be dangerous, not just outside, but inside as well. Those with poor heating systems or those without heat will want to watch out for hypothermia. Thermia, that happens when your body temperature is lower than 95 degrees. Also, a good time to remind you to keep generators, stoves, anything that's creating heat that's not actually part of your house system, keep that all outside, because that can also be a problem during this cold weather. Live in the newsroom tonight, I'm David Charnes, News Channel 5 Nightcast.